What's up guys, so welcome back to the channel. So yeah, again a special thanks to everyone who supported so far. All the subscribers and all the people who shared the videos. Yeah, I appreciate it. So yeah, today we have a Mach 1 with a VVL swap. So we have the guy here of the Mach 1, so his name is Wasim.
Salam bro.
Salam, welcome to the channel.
Thanks man.
So yeah, we're gonna start it off by asking you why you actually went this specific route with the VVL swap.
Okay, so basically I had like a couple of STIs, GXIs before. Probably like 10 of it. And then after selling my last one, I decided, okay, something different. The car was built by my brother, named Rustin. So he basically built the car, putting the whole motor setup in, and afterwards he got caught up with a lot of other stuff, and then didn't have time to finish the car basically. So that's when I came in, and I decided to buy the car by him. And did some small odds and ends basically to get the car in a driving condition. So by odds and ends, it was like water pipes, alternator wasn't fitted, car needed a battery, and also wheels for the car. Car was basically staying on spare wheels and stuff like that. Yeah, so when my brother bought the car, it was 2 liter 812, and then he decided he's gonna go with VVL in the car. So yeah, it all started from the 2 liter ABL, took the motor out and everything. And then also with the help of Riyad, known as Yata, he also gave a hand to the whole conversion thing. And then yeah, when the motor was out, the car went in for spray. The car was originally white, so we sprayed it gray. The color is calculated gray, and yeah, went from there.
So seeing that this car is actually powered by a VVL, is there any engine mods that you added onto the motor or inside the motor?
Nothing as yet. The motor is still completely stock. Stock pistons, stock cams, everything is stock basically still. Going forward, I would like to do some mods, yeah, like cams and stuff like that. I would like to do that in the future with the car. I just have a normal breathing mods like cold air induction, bronze, and 63mm exhaust, one box. And yeah, that's basically it.
Yeah, and with regard to the gearbox, what are you running there?
It's still a normal golf gearbox I'm running with. Obviously, some mixed gears. So going forward, I would like to put LS in as well, because it's still an open diff box. So yeah, LS is obviously gonna help me with spinning issues that I have. So yeah, that's also one of the stuff that I want to upgrade going forward.
So you said that this car is actually a race car, eh? And for the shoot, you actually just made it into a street car.
Yeah, I just made it into a street daily car so that I can drive around. But it was built with the intention for a race car, yeah. So I actually made the car like full inside, the interior, with back seats and all. So basically I use the car on a daily basis, driving on the road and stuff. So it's not just gonna be used for track and that.
So the Mach 1 did manage to do a 14.8 second run on the quarter mile with a 60 foot time of 2.45 seconds. However, if you look at the exit speed, it's clear to see that he might have tapped off before the quarter mile mark, which affected his time. So yeah. So with street tires and traction issues, the Mark 1 managed a 0-100 time of 6.8 seconds. You actually didn't run in the track yet, no?
Kelani.
So what do you actually think of the time that you ran?
For me it's fine because I'm still driving on the street tires. Maybe if I put a proper tire on, and the time will obviously differ from me, yeah.
And another thing, the traction was on, no? So yeah. The street tires. And you can't really compare the track to the street.
Exactly, yeah. Basically, still having standard mountings, no poly mountings as yet.
Standard Mark 1 mounts.
Standard Mark 1 mounts. Yeah. Bit of an alteration, basically, but it's still standard mountings. As you can see by the gearbox as well, still standard mountings. And then, basically, for the stability, I only have a
strut bar.
The top strut bar as well at the bottom is one.
The induction.
Yeah, basically I'm still in the future still planning to get me a one piece induction. Cut this out and make it more neater. And yeah.
So who actually tunes this car?
Okay, so basically the car is road tuned. It was tuned by Jason De Sousa. So I actually don't know what power the car is making, but looking at 150 to 155 kilowatts.
Seeing that it's a standard DVL.
Standard DVL, yeah. So yeah, that's basically where the power should be at, yeah.
So do you actually plan on doing some power runs in future, just to see where the price is?
Say so, one or two power runs just to see where the car is before now doing any modifications on the car. Yeah. Just take it from there again.
Was there any like hiccups along the way doing the swap in the Mark 1?
Not actually, because this was actually the second one that we did.
Oh, okay.
So yeah, the first one was basically like a trial and error move. So this one basically came out clean, basically, because ever since start up and driving after the tune, I never really had any issues
yeah.
Like car brake, like boxes maybe or stuff like that. Nothing. The car is still running from day one.
And the nice thing with this car, if you see it on the road, you'll just think it's a normal 1.4.
Yeah, but so that was the whole idea of keeping the car like as clean as possible, looking on the road. Like to fit in with the other road cars.
So suspension wise, what setup are you running?
So basically in front I have a lowering kit, a 40 mm lowering kit. At the back I have a sleeve overs in with a BMW springs, just to stiffen it up. So yeah, basically when it's a race night or whenever we have some privates going on, I basically just turn it up at the back. It's better from the line when it's, you know, aerodynamics and all that stuff.
I really thought that this is actually a white, but like you said, it's actually a calculator grade.
Yeah,
huh?
Yeah, it's called yeah. Calculator grade.
Plays
yeah.
With your mind. It's actually a nice color, very uncommon.
Yeah, so basically I have a stabilizer bar at the back as well. And as you can see here, the spare wheel, it's cut out, so it's closed.
That weight reduction.
Weight reduction, yeah.
Yeah, so this is the end of this episode, so yeah, shukran again to Wasim.
thanks a lot, man. And thanks for having me on the channel. Much appreciated.
If you guys enjoyed this video, please do consider subscribing if you haven't. And do like the video. And comment also what you enjoyed most about the video. So yeah.